Thank you very much. We'll move from sound to ultrasound. My name is Claude Cohen-Bacry. I've been working in the field of ultrasound for the last 25 years. I used to be in charge of research for Philips Medical, based in the US. I founded a first company called Supersonic Imagine in 2005 that manufactured basically the system on the left here, a premium ultrasound system for radiology that was sold to Hologic. And today, with these topics, what we want to do is really transform ultrasound into a software. And this is the way we're going to use to democratize ultrasound. We're going to do that as a service because we're going to change the business model of ultrasound as well, with a unique IP-protected software platform, as you will see, that will enable us to develop a series of apps, each targeting a specific clinical indication for several clinical specialists. We believe it's the ultimate transformation of ultrasound simply because softwareizing a digital technology has happened in other industries, in the camera industry, for example. The reason why we're able to have pretty pictures on our camera, on our smartphone, is because there's software running there. So the problem we are targeting is the problem of that bottleneck that patients go through in the patient workflow. And the bottleneck is because there's a shortage of radiologists, a shortage of sonographer to get an ultrasound for the diagnosis of your disease. And as you can see here, ultrasound has already miniaturized itself, creating a completely new market that was probably back in 2005 called point-of-care market. The concept of point-of-care is basically to bring the ultrasound system to the patient rather than bringing the patient to the radiology department. And point-of-care has two examples of two different markets here, emergency and anesthesiology. The important thing to understand in point-of-care ultrasound is that it is the fastest growing market in ultrasound, 1.5 million growing at 8% CAGR over an overall ultrasound market of 7 billion. And that's the reason why we want to go into this market with additional what we call biomarkers, differentiating biomarkers that are going to help the adoption of ultrasound by non-expert users. And as you will see, we're going to do that both upstream for detection and downstream for intervention. The existing point-of-care devices today, and I'm taking two examples here, Butterfly and Philips, have miniaturized the hardware of a conventional ultrasound system. And of course, when you do that, you have to manage power consumption and energy consumption and elevation of temperature, which forces you to do compromise in imaging. And they have decent B-mode imaging, decent black and white imaging, but still, you still have to have an expertise to interpret these images in order to use them. What Iscopix is doing, we are not miniaturizing a hardware architecture. We are dematerializing the architecture of an ultrasound system, making it a software. Think about Spotify. You no longer buy a sound system, you just register to Spotify. That's exactly what we do with ultrasound. And the interesting concept that we can that we can leverage by doing this dematerialization is that we no longer have to make compromise on image quality, but also compromise on all these other quantitative imaging biomarkers that you have on premium ultrasound and that we no longer had on existing point-of-care devices. We've solved the power consumption issue, and we can also retrieve quantitative imaging modes, quantitative imaging modes as shown here in color on this image, which actually displays the stiffness of the liver. And as you will understand, displaying quantitative parametric imaging of tissue helps you give a diagnosis without even having any expertise on that. Stiffness of your liver tells you exactly about the fibrosis content in your liver. So without expertise, a diabetologist, an hepatologist will be able to diagnose fibrosis in the liver. So far, after 4 years of existence, we have put a first product on the market. It's kind of a proof of concept of this platform of dematerialized ultrasound that is able to in real time image the liver and also locate region of interest where you can do measurements of stiffness that tells you about the fibrosis in your liver and measurements of steatosis biomarker. It's an app, it's a software that you download on your computer. You have a transducer that you use and plug on your computer, and here you have your ultrasound system. With this first product, with this first app, we are targeting a huge market, the market of type 2 diabetes having NAFLD NASH, but also the market of obesity developing NAFLD. NAFLD is a serious problem. One every four people in this room has fat in his liver or her liver. And of course, it's not dangerous, but you have to monitor the beginning of fibrosis in this liver to get on drug or to get on a specific diet. So that was upstream as a screening tool for NASH, but we also have been able to get a first customer on intravascular ultrasound, leveraging the fact that our platform is low power and low energy consumption. So we are going to progressively map applications and develop applications. We don't want to do end product. We don't want to be a B2C company, but rather a B2B company, trying to provide this platform to any company wanting to develop a point of care tool, either upstream or downstream. And we started with the liver application and the vascular application, but we have already identified customers that want to, with us, develop this application to democratize the use of ultrasound at point of care, again, both upstream and downstream. We have an experienced team. Today, Iscopix is a 15-people team with track record in ultrasound company development, and also supported by a very strong clinical board, mainly oriented towards liver for now. So what we've done at Iscopix is we believe we've found the solution to point of care in a low power, ultra-fast imaging capability, capable to have premium capability in point of care. We basically want to develop an ultrasound as a service business model targeting businesses. It's a B2B strategy, an Iscopix inside type of strategy. And of course, when you start to introduce ultrasound within community of users, community being the clinical specialist, you start to generate data. And you start to learn from this data and move towards preventive and predictive care, and that's our goal. I will end by telling you that we have been lucky to have the opportunity to show you the device at the Innovators Pavilion. On table 21, we have a model that gets a scan. You can take the probe, you can use it, you will see that we really have democratized ultrasound. You will be able to perform the ultrasound and measure fibrosis and steatosis in the liver of our model. And with this, I'd like to thank you very much for your attention.